Hello everybody and welcome back to another episode of Film Station 3000. Today we're bringing back Jaji, our special effects artist, to teach you guys three simple ways to make some fake blood. And you can eat it too. Dinner, anybody? You sure? No?
Hey guys, today I'm going to teach you three ways to make different texture blood you can use in your movies or just to scare your friends. And it's edible. Here's what you need. Corn syrup, water, red, blue, green food coloring dye, cornstarch, and last but not least, chocolate syrup. My first blood is less thicker than the next two. I started by measuring 1 cup of water and 1 cup of light corn syrup. I added them both to an old bowl. I decided to put on some gloves because fake blood has been known to temporarily stain skin and clothes. I add about 15 to 20 drops of red food dye. This will give a bright red blood, which isn't realistic looking. We're going to want to change that shade. So we will darken this mix with about half a tablespoon of chocolate syrup. This will give you a darker maroon color. Now we'll add a bit of cornstarch to thicken this mixture. You can keep adjusting the texture by adding cornstarch to thicken or water to loosen. You can now see cornstarch bubbles floating on top, and you can either take them out or just keep mixing it until it's smooth. I added about 1 drop of both blue and green food dye and as much red as needed. This is my final product. Here's my second way to make blood. This one is more like a blood gel. I used corn syrup, red jello or gelatin knox, and red, blue, and green food coloring dye. My second blood is more gel textured. I'm going to start with my corn syrup. Measure 1 cup of corn syrup and pour it into your bowl. The next step would be the cherry gelatin. I use 1 packet of cherry jello, but this can be substituted by 1 packet of Knox gelatin unflavored. Mix it and you will see it will be a little grainy and thick. This is okay. This is the correct consistency. As you mix it, you can see that the color is really bright. So I use 1 drop of blue, 1 drop of green, and about 10 and 15 drops of red food coloring dye to reach the correct shade I'd like. As you can see as you mix it, this gives you a thick gel-like blood. This will look great on wounds and stick well. This is my third way to make blood. I used pancake syrup, blue Gatorade, and red and green food coloring dye. First, I'm going to start by adding pancake syrup into my bowl. It doesn't really matter how much, as later on I can change the consistency of the blood by adding more syrup or Gatorade. I will next add 1 drop of green dye, followed by about 10 or 15 drops of red dye. You will mix it until it is a dark maroon color. Once you get that color, you can add some blue Gatorade. I will start adding a bit at a time so I can check the consistency. Stir it and fix consistency by adding more syrup if you'd like. You can fix the color by adding red if it's too light or Gatorade if it's too dark. My final product is a slightly gooey, real feeling, and looking type of blood. This is perfect for movies.